I want you to turn with me, if you don't mind, to Romans chapter 8, verse 26. When you found it, would you please stand? Romans chapter 8, verse 26. I'm going to read to you, kind of because we need to condense, if you would, what could turn out to be about 15 verses. We're not going to read that much to you. I'm reading from the English Standard Version of the Bible. Are you ready? So I'll just read out loud. You can just kind of read to yourself in whatever translation you have. It reads, "Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. For we know not what to pray for as we ought, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us with groanings too deep for words. And he who searches hearts knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. And we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good, for those who are called according to his purpose." How many of you know you're called according to his purpose? "For those whom he foreknew, he also predestinated to be conformed to the image of his Son, in order that he might be the firstborn among many brothers. And those whom he predestinated, he also called. And those whom he called, he also justified. And those whom he justified, he also glorified." That's powerful, right? Amen. So he predestines you. He calls you into the thing that you're ordained to do. When you come, you may have dirty hands, stuff you've done, out of sorts, on the wrong track. Then God then justifies you by his grace, his righteousness, his holiness, his blood. Amen. And those who he justifies, that means it's an exchange there. You receive from him, then he glorifies. What does that mean? His grace and anointing, authority and power comes upon that which once was common, but now has been set apart or sanctified. Forgive that little exhortation there. Let's go on. What then shall we say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also with him graciously give us all things? Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? Who's God's elect? Who? So who shall bring any charge against God's elect? What does that mean? It means the accuser of the brethren, Satan, is always trying to say, you're not good enough, you're not worthy enough, you're not this, you're not that, you're not the other. Are you there with me? But he says there's no way that the qualified, bona fide, certified, and really received accusation or charge can be brought against the elect of God.